So what I'm doing here is I'm going to mix my, I have a neutral gesso, which this is the first time I'm using this, so it'll be a new experiment for me. And I'm mixing it with my blue, red, and yellow that I'm going to use in my final composition. The reason I'm doing this is I want to make sure that the colors mesh, but also I want a dark beneath everything to start with. As the project comes along, you'll see more why I would say that. But what I've done is I've squeezed all three of them out now. Get my brush wet. I always want to start with a wet brush. That way it does, the paints will not get stuck in the bristles as far as for permanence sake. And I want to be careful not to sling my paint all over my room. We can see it starts creating. I love just doing this right on the canvas. It creates this cool rainbow of colors, if you will. And I use my old bristle brush that I don't care if it gets a little scruffy because I'm having to scrub it. This canvas, what I've done is I've textured it really well using a natural sponge and a medium molding paste. It's coming out a little greener than I would like. So what I'm going to do is add some more red. So it'll kind of neutralize. The blue that I'm using is called phthalo blue, and it is probably the most powerful blue as far as taking over a palette that is out there. And you can see how it just really, even with that, cadmium red's a strong color, and it has to fight to make an impact with that blue. I've got a nice neutral. I don't necessarily want a green on him, so I just grab a little color from another spot, push it in there. I don't mind that it's leaning towards the red or to the blue. I just want to make sure whenever it's done that the color that I get is close to a neutral, but with the darker essence of the blues and the reds. The yellow is just more to keep it from getting too purple. I'm going to turn this around a second. Sorry. There we go. That way I can see it from a different light. Make sure that I get all this. I want it pushed in, worked in the gesso, the colored gesso. I want it just pushed into the canvas to make sure the whole thing is covered. I do not like white specks whenever I'm going with something like this. In fact, looking at my composition, there's not going to be any white anywhere in this painting. There'll be lighter colors, but it'll never get all the way to white. And so I do not want any white specks showing through. And this is good, that way I get a little better lighting too. I can see some of my white specks trying to peek through. What happens sometimes when you're brushing over it also, you push bubbles across the surface, and then when those bubbles pop, you realize you got a little white dot underneath there. So sometimes what I'll do is actually after I've lifted up, just drop it like that, and it'll kind of help pop some of those bubbles. Looks like I about got them all. What I'm going to do right now is just block in some more of the darks. So I'm going to, I've got this little black and white printout. I like this black and white because it gives me a good opportunity to see just the values And that's what I'm after right here, is just the values. Let's get these darks and lights figured out, and then the color will pretty much find itself. Okay, well, I've worked a lot of the darks in, and I still got several, you know, areas to go, but now I'm working more towards the lights for a while to just start bringing in some of the other colors in the light areas. This is going to be a plaid shirt whenever it's all finished, so what I'll do is I'll just slowly work a few colors in here and there, and as time goes on, you'll start seeing it beginning to pop out. It's got, you can start seeing how the lights will make the fabric, the folds pop a little bit more. There's a long ways to go here, but we're definitely starting to see some progress. I'm going to go for a little bit of, I need a little more of an orangey color this time. As I left off earlier, I was just finishing up the shirt, and I decided to just go ahead and continue painting, not on camera, just to go ahead and get it wrapped up. I figured you saw enough of me painting, and I just wanted to go ahead and move in and get started. So what I've done is I've actually come in and I've finished the face now. I've come in, done some more touch-up on the shirt. I also did some more work on the jeans. Did a little bit of touch-up into the bricks to blend them back a little bit more, to soften my lights and my darks. I wanted them pushed back a little bit. You'll also see that here in the cardboard underneath him, I brought in some more work over here to just kind of round that out and finish it. My reference photo that I had taken did not have the cardboard extending like this. It looked differently. It felt lost. It got lost in the shadows, and so I took one of my artistic liberties to go ahead and make it reference a little bit of the edge of the cardboard like it was the flaps right there. Same thing in the back. I had some really dark shadows back here originally. I decided to brighten it up. I did not want anything you to question why was there a shadow there. So what we have now is him just pretty much in the light and just laying there, hidden in plain sight.